Hello students, welcome to Study Tricks. In this session, we are going to start a new part, that is Introducing Social Sciences of 10th CBSE textbook. In this session, we will be studying the very first chapter of Political Science part, that is Power Sharing. Without wasting time, let us start the session. In previous year, that is in class 9th, we have seen what is democracy and how democracy helps people. In this chapter, we will be seeing how different parts in the world have struggled to start democracy in their respective societies. We know that democracy has power distributed among various departments like legislative, executive, and judiciary. This is the main important thing in democracy. In this chapter, we will see the stories of Belgium and Sri Lankan countries, how they initially handled the demands of power sharing. And let us come to Indian society after detailedly seeing Belgium and Sri Lankan societies. Belgium and Sri Lanka, both are a very small countries, almost near to the size of Indian state Haryana. Belgium has bordering states of France, Netherlands, Germany and Luxembourg. In Belgium, the main problem was there were various ethnic compositions in the country. Look in the map. The yellow color part was occupied by Flemish region. This is a Flemish region in which people there spoke Dutch language. In southern part, that is red color shaded region, people spoke French. There was a rivalry between these two people. These two are almost equal in their population. Like German people are very less. German speaking people used to live in this small shaded region. Okay, these people have wars in between these people have many clashes in between them. Flemish people who speak Dutch were almost 40% this region, yellow region, and whereas French speaking people were almost 59% of the Belgium population. And minority French speaking community was relatively rich compared to Dutch speaking people. French speaking people were relatively rich. That means this red shaded region people are relatively rich. What happens once if they are relatively rich? They seek more power compared to the other community. This is what happened in the Belgium community also. The Dutch speaking community who got benefit of economic development and education much later after so many struggles. Initially, French were only dominant because they were rich. During 1950s and 1960s, these tensions arose between both Dutch and French-speaking people. Apart from these two, the other main intention was this orange-shaded region. Small part is Brussels, the capital of Belgium. This again had a very special problem. Here, Dutch-speaking people were majority in the country, but in capital they were minority, whereas in the whole country Dutch speaking were majority. We have seen in this, right? Dutch speaking people were majority people, but in the capital, if you observe, they were minority because capital was most occupied by other people apart from Dutch people. This was their problem. And we'll see what is the problem faced by Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka has very diverse populations. Like, majority of the groups were Sinhalese speakers, other were Tamilian speakers. Again, in Tamilians also, there were the native Tamilians of Sri Lanka, known as Sri Lankan Tamilians, and people whose forefathers were in India and they went to Sri Lanka as plantation workers during colonial period and settled there. They were known as Indian Tamilians. So there were totally three different groups of communities in Sri Lanka. That is Sinhalese speaking, Sri Lankan Tamilians and Indian Tamilians. As you can see in this map, this orange region was Sri Lankan Tamilians. They were mostly in the north and northeastern part of the country. Whereas majority were Sinhalese speaking and Indian Tamilians were in the southern region. This was the composition of Sri Lanka. Then, here also clearly the leaders of Sinhalese community were dominating in the governance, because in 1948 when the country became independent, Sinhali community got dominance in the government. As the result, majoritarian measures, that is popularism measures, like if a political leader from Sinhali group was there, he used to favor those people only. That was increasing day by day after this independence. Majoritarian measures to establish Sinhalese supremacy started over there. In 1956, extreme stage happened, that is, Sinhalese was recognized as an official language, disregarding Tamilians. You know, this struggle happens in almost majority of the countries, and here also the same. In 1956, Sinhalese was officially a state language. They disregarded Tamil. This started agitations among Tamilians. Apart from this, a new constitution was also stipulated. This gave certain preference to Buddhists who are present in Tamilian, but completely neglected Muslim region and also Tamil-speaking regions. All these government measures were coming one after the other, which made Sri Lankan Tamils to feel alienated, like they were feeling disregarded by government measures. They felt that constitution and government is completely stopping their political rights, that is denying them equal political rights. They are recognizing the other community languages, they are giving reservations in the university seats, but they are degrading Tamilians. As the result, the relations between Sinhalese and Tamilian communities were worst. What happened at this point is, Sri Lankan Tamils launched parties and struggles for recognition of Tamil as an official language. They started fighting officially. In 1980s, several political organizations were also formed. These political organizations were demanding a separate state for Tamil, naming independent Tamil Eelam, that is Tamil state. They wanted northern and eastern parts of Sri Lanka, where they were dominated, to be a separate state. This soon turned into a civil war. You know that Sri Lanka was economically rich. This we will be seeing in economics part. They were initially having a good, excellent record of economy, but because of this civil war, they got deteriorated, and by the end of 2009, they could slowly recover. Since 1960s till 2006, where they were not economically good because of civil wars continuously happening in Sri Lanka. Now, we have seen the conditions of Belgium and Sri Lanka. Though the areas geographically were different, but their problem was the majoritarian communities dominating the minoritarian communities. In almost every country, we see this problem. Majority part of the community always degrades the minority part of the community, which arouses to a kind of civil war or a political war between these two communities. And the best suited way to handle such community problems is always democracy. In the case of Belgium and Sri Lanka also, what happens we will be seeing in the next session. With this, I am ending this section. Stay tuned to Study Tricks. Please do subscribe and share the channel for more lessons.